You know, it actually blows my mind that we have not done one on pan yet, so it's time to open up the bakery and see more of that cakery. To be honest with you, pan or bread, depending on how specific you want to be, is, I think, the first Lolly character I ever really had a crush on, honestly. And it was at a time where, honestly, I didn't even know what the concept of Lolly was. But as time goes on, yeah, I think it makes a lot of sense. I remember the times where Pan, honestly, didn't even get a lot of fan art. The most she had was, like, 20 pictures. And it was a whack time. I was like, damn, I want to see Pan content, honestly. I want to see just her getting plowed in different ways. But it didn't happen until very much later, where we're in the now, where we're absolutely just in the pan content. Literally a whole artist is dedicated to her, and you have quite literally just other people just going through and making nice decent content of her with that fat ass, which we already discussed. If she's wearing jeans, we know that there's a reason for it. There's just plenty of fan art that is absolutely just good, adorable, and honestly high, like the Kishin Pain one that people still ask me for to this day. In fact, I was asked this morning, would I drop this picture? And no, I will not be dropping this picture, at least not yet. There is two that he drew and people still ask me for it. So here's what the plan is. You want to see the full picture? Get my ass to 5k. You want to see the other one? Get my ass to 10k. Simple as that. Mainly also, I don't want to draw any more attention to Kishin Pain, honestly, when it comes down to, you know, this whole situation that he had to go through. But still, nonetheless, I will keep my word and drop those shits if you get to 5k and 10k. So work on that, please. Like, to be honest, she's so OG when it comes to just Genocide material, honestly, that she just feels like, you know, the same level of Gwen from Ben 10, honestly. Like, they feel like they're on the very much same level, or should be treated on the same level, even though Pain don't get that treatment, but she should, though. Which you also want to know is equally crazy, and if you really think about it in canon, how did no one do this? Literally, if you think about it, we got to actually see Pan grow from a small person to a bigger person to an older person. And when it comes down to it, you mean to tell me, don't nobody in the DBZ universe, when the whole thing of her getting older happened, you mean to tell me no one clapped her cheeks? Literally, because yes, she took care of Goku Jr., but that's not her kid. That's literally like a, I think, nephew or like a, you know, grandson. Yeah, I think a grandson. So when it comes down to it, she didn't have kids herself. You mean to tell me that no one pounded her cheeks before she got to that point? To me, this is the most disrespectful thing I think Dragon Ball ever did. No one bothered to clap Pan's cheeks. That's the equivalent of literally having free rein in a chest, but you don't take advantage of that. It's literally also the case if, like, Rias was like on your bed ready to present everything to you, but then you just throw a blanket on her and just say good night. That's literally like if you had the whole MHA universe full of women and literally had them as your own captive slaves for all dirty reasons, but then you let them go and then you just give them $5,000 each. What is wrong with you? Do you think my people suffer 565 years of slavery for using not clap pants cheeks? Do I look like Chicken George to you? What the hell is that? This literally means Pan was a virgin from the beginning to the very end of her own ass existence, which is some non-effing sense. Hopefully Xeno Pan at least spread her cheeks around a little bit. I mean, she is going to different universes or whatever the hell she does, so it would be nice to see her get her cheeks ran a few times, where the original Pan never did, and I still don't understand how. This is the most egregious crime, like figuring out who the hell built and made sliced bread. Which honestly, because Pan is literally named bread, that would just mean that we're talking about her quarter pound ass cheeks, which I am perfectly fine for. Which, speaking of quarter pounder, if we have Pan like right here, right, and then we had Wendy's also right there, and they pushed her ass cheeks together with my meat in between, does this mean that we created a Dave single? And if I were to bust all over that, then there would be a Dave single with extra mayo. Which I would be down for that.